Hey, what's up guys? Today's video we will use the new emergency buffed Skeleton King in this Electro Giant deck. So a ton of people were playing this deck, and so the Dark Prince just the Skeleton King. The Skeleton King got a really huge buff. It's gonna be the damage increased by 14%, the area of damage increased by 30%, and also it's not gonna get pushback besides from tubes from logs. So honestly, a really big buff to Skeleton King. So let's see how the newly buffed Skeleton King does against the best place in the world in ladder. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future on the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Also, using creator code mod is highly appreciated. I appreciate any one of you supporting me. And I would say, let's jump straight into the games and let's take some great dubs with the newly buffed Skeleton King. Here we go, guys. Here in the first game, let's see how the newly emergency buff Skeleton King will do in this deck. Also, the Archer King got a small nerf, but I still think she's gonna be broken because it's right now the best card in Clash Royale. I think the thing I'm gonna do right now is just going for Skeleton King at the river, at the bridge opposite lane. Just gonna force it some elixir, and I think I'm just gonna use the ultimate ability. You guys can see the range of the attack is way bigger than it used to be before, which really helps in situation, also doing more damage. So it looks like it's going to be a lava clone matchup, and I think we have a really great matchup against lava clone. So if you guys hate lava clone, play this deck. And honestly, the Skeleton King, I think you saw the nerf, you saw the buff already, like a nerf for sure. He doesn't even, he didn't need a nerf. But I think you guys saw the buff already, doing more damage or more splash damage, bigger radius against all of the Skeleton Army stuff. So, I'm just gonna go for an Electro Giant here. I mean, it's not the optimal Electro Giant, but I think it's okay to do this in situation. So he still needs to defend an Electro Giant Bomber push. I don't really think it's too much, especially his queen is out of cycle. So he's going for a baby dragon, which will not be enough. We're gonna get a ton of damage here. And I think I'm just gonna go for a Skeleton King here. Skeleton King might be the play. Okay, I could just tornado this, but I don't really think I need to. Let's see, how much damage is the Skeleton King doing alone? Okay, 300. Taking that, I'm just going for Mother Witch High. In this matchup so far, Skeleton King is doing some work in because, yeah, for sure, makes sense, right? I kind of want to wait here to Lightning because I want the Mana Witch to lock on top of the Queen. Now I can Lightning that and we will get his tower. So he will go for Lava in the back now because he has a ton of spam, right? If he has a ton of spam, it's normally the matchup where the Skeleton King shines. Also, he doesn't have Valkyrie, he doesn't have Bomber, no Bomb Tower, so not really a splash unit against my Skeleton King. And Infernity in the back. Let's go. Infernity is coming down. Electro Giant is coming down. Okay, this will be an annoying push, as I feel like. Okay, I'm just gonna go for this. I mean, we actually defended this quite easily, so I'm just gonna go for Skeleton King here, kind of absorb the damage. Okay. That's fine, right? That's fine, right? I'm just going for the Inferno Dragon in the back. And I'm just going to go for Electro Giant in front of this. Why I'm going for Electro Giant in front of this? Because I just want that he's not able to get a really great clone out of us, on us. I'm just going to go for a tornado here. And I think this is it. GG's well played. We're winning the first one. I think, honestly, the Skeleton King did a really solid job, but yeah, generally really great matchup for us. If you guys hate Lava Clone, this Electro Giant Skeleton King deck is absolutely insane against it. Here we go, guys. Here in the next game, and we play against Josky Wissey. I don't really know how to pronounce his name, but he's playing Wallbreaker, so we're just gonna go for Skeleton King on top of his Miner. Okay, looks like it's going to be Miner Wallbreaker. He has Valkyrie most likely, so let's see how the Skeleton King is doing in this matchup. I think the damage is kind of recognizable, the damage buff and also the range. So his test is out of cycle. I'm just going to go for an E-Giant right in the back. Okay. I'm a Fire Dragon here. I mean, he could Fireball that, but this is a ton of elixirs, so I'm thinking we could go in for a Tower Trade potentially. I mean, I don't really know how he's going to be able to defend this. Okay, I'm just going to honestly go for Skeleton King opposite lane here. And I'm just going to use the ability instant. Okay, maybe with the ability we can kill his Valkyrie. Okay, no. But the thing was, like, why I did that, even looked kind of weird. Because I just want to make sure that he's not able to defend. If he would have gone for Valkyrie on the right side, he might still have defended that. So I went really on the left side, really aggressive. So just to make sure to get one tower. Because if I get one tower in this matchup, normally I'm in a really great position. So it looked like an overcommitment. It was maybe an overcommitment, but at the end, I still think it was the right decision to go in that aggressive. Because he would have defended on the right side, I would have got his left tower. So I just want to make sure that. So also well played by him. Well played by him. Kind of was one step ahead of me. I'm just going to Mother Witch here. Getting three hawks out of this is not that bad. And I think right now just about playing defense. I'm just going to go for a Fandring in here. I'm just going to go for a Skeleton here. I just hope the Skeleton King is going to kill the Wall Breakers. No Skeleton King. Don't really want, but also my piggies were chipping away. So I might just bomber here. Good bomber. And I'm just gonna cage here. Like, why not? Gonna cage here, then he cannot go in and up in the pocket. And right now I'm just gonna go for an Electro Chain. Just wanna make sure that they're gonna build up a huge push. Gonna lightning his Tesla. I hope he's gonna give me some lightning. But I'm also gonna go for a Skeleton King opposite lane. Kinda like mixing it up. Let's see. I really want to go on with this, and I'm just going to go for a Bomber High. Mother Witch is coming down. Let's see, what is his next play? He needs to go for another Tesla normally. No, he's not. Okay, this is going to be enough. I didn't really expect him to be enough. Okay, I'm just going to go in for a Tornado here. I'm also going to go for a Bomber here, because he needs to go in for a Tesla now. That's what he did. So for sure the right play. But also get a really good Infernoing. We might get one shot from Electrogyne. No, we don't. Okay, let's see. I might just drop another Electrogyne in the bridge. In the back. Cage here. Good cage. Okay, he gets one shot. Lightning. Going for a bomber in the pocket. Let's see. He has another Electro Giant. I mean, not Tesla ready against my Electro Giant. Cage here. Good cage. Good cage. So I'm just going to go for Mother Witch here. Drinks coming down, let's go. I'm just gonna go for an E-Giant in front of this. Okay, let's see. What is his next play going to be? He's gonna Tesla here, okay. Mother Witch. Bomber, Tornado. The E-Giant locks. The question, what is faster? The E-Giant or the Fireball? Oh, come back.
Who are you?
Woohoo! Let's go. Here we go, guys. Here, next game, and we play against Axel. So, if I see Fire Spirit and Wallbreaker, I'm thinking of playing against. Okay, I messed up the King Duration, but it's okay, it's okay. Yeah, Drill. Most likely it's going to be Drill. We have some solid answers against Drill. I mean, Skeleton King should do a good job. Similar to the Dark Winds against it. Also, one-shots Goblins. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna go for Mother Witch here. That's okay. And I'm just gonna cage here most likely. I think it's a solid play. Just going for a safe cage here. Cannot really go Wallbreaker now to pressure us. And if he goes in for Drill, I have Bomber. So, let's see. I mean, he's just going to Warbreak Kite there most likely. Yes, that was expected.
Yeah, Drill. Most likely it's going to be Drill.
I felt scripted.
Just going for Tornado here. Let's go. And we still, like, we're washed. We're messing this up, which is not good. I'm just going for Inferno Ring here. Also going for a Bomber here.
That wasn't well played. Let's see. He's gonna Valkyrie here. Just gonna go Skeleton King, I think. Okay, let's see. I'm just gonna cage here. Use the ability. Let's see, what's he gonna do next? I'm just gonna go Tornado here, pull it into the Skeleton King. And he's back to another, but we got one splash shot. We got one splash shot. I'm just going for Foundering High. Going for a Bomber here. I'm also going for a Cage here. Also going for a Skeleton King here. One shot the Goblins. Okay. I'm playing my Mother Witch High. Inferno Drake here. Using the ability, let's go. The Inferno D-Lock's on, we're just gonna tornado everything. The Inferno D-Lock's on, the Skeleton's tank. So honestly, the Skeleton King, we didn't need the Electro Giant. This is normally a really tough matchup without the Skeleton King, but the Skeleton King even against Bomber plus Valkyrie did an awesome job distracting everything that Inferno D-Lock's on. GG's well played. Electro Giant plus Skeleton King might be the combo of the year. Here we go, guys. Here we're hopefully in the final game for this video. I really want to end the video with a win. So let's just hope he's going to give us a juicy win, a juicy dub. So if I see a Heal Spirit plus Bandit, I think about Bridge Member of Three Musketeers. I'm just going to cycle my Inferno Ring to left because I want to activate King Tower. Go activate King Tower, sir. Let's go. Okay. Ghost is coming down. Okay, we have, if he has Warlocks, let's see how the Skeleton King will do against Warlocks with the bigger splash and more damage. Should be better than before. I mean, would be kind of weird if he would do worse than before with a buff. Okay. Honestly, thinking about just going in with an Electro Giant here. I mean, Pump is not that bad. Okay, I'm just gonna go for a Bomber. Please, Skeleton King, please protect this. Let's go, Skeleton King. Now we're gonna use the ability here. We're gonna use the ability. He doesn't have his Barbarian Balance Cycle anymore, so let's see how the ability is doing. The ability, the Skeleton King. Let's go, Skeleton King, let's go. He splashes the tower all the time. He splashes the tower all the time. He actually defended that really, really well. And that's kind of the only reason why we didn't get too much damage. So he honestly defended really well. We still got some damage. But we also need to keep in mind that he has a pump on the map. Okay, this is not going to be enough, so he needs to spend more elixir. This is honestly a really easy defense with the cage, so we're looking not too bad, honestly. Because, yes, he had a pump on his map, but the pump didn't really gain too much elixir for him. Because, like, look at this. He said, like, he has a pump on the map, we are at 7. So the only play you could really do is going for another pump. And this basically means it's going to double elixir time. He doesn't have his E-buffs in cycle. This is our time to go just with E-Giant and the bridge because the E-buffs are out of cycle. The only play you could really do right now is just going for 3 musketeers in the back. And I'm just going to try to lightning his pump. And yeah, the pump and the 1 musketeer. I think it's a solid play there. I mean, it might be even a better play than just lighting the 2 musketeers. Because now we make sure he's not going to be in a big elixir advantage. I'm just going to really like, I need to take damage now. This is what we know. Okay, I'm just going for a cage here. I'm kind of waiting for a Seal Spirit. I'm going for a defensive Electro Giant here. Defensive Electro Giant is coming down. Let's go. I'm killing most of them. I'm just going for a Skeleton King here. Skeleton King will do this. I'm just going to bomb behind my tower. Okay, now I'm just going to go for hopefully a perfect NATO. I'm just going for Mother Witch here. And we got a really great defense. Bomb behind the tower. We took some damage, but I knew we have to take some damage, right? If he wouldn't have taken any damage, yeah, he would have just overwhelmed me. So really clean defense. What do you guys think about Skeleton King? Like at the end, I would say it's a really solid card now. It's not as good as I thought. Maybe this deck is not the best deck with it. I still need to find out like some different variations. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's one. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Also using Creator Good Mod and let me know what you guys think about the new Skeleton King. I'm out. Thanks for watching and goodbye, guys.